Hello and welcome to Share Talk. I am Bonnie Hughes. Our very interesting guest today is Conroy Gold and Natural Resources. They have a project in Northern Ireland, projects in Northern Finland, and they just recently published some assay results on 8 of their drill holes for the summer drilling season. And here to tell us all about the company and their plans for the future is Richard Conroy, chairman of Conroy Gold and Natural Resources. Hello, Richard, and thank you very much for joining us.
Oh, thank you, indeed, and for having the opportunity of saying a few words about our company. We've been involved in natural resources for many years. We discovered, for example, the Galmoy zinc ore bodies, which resulted in the revival of the Irish base metals industry. But we've also had the view that Ireland had gold potential. Now, this isn't recognized in the industry, even though if you go to the National Museum in Ireland, you'll see some of the most wonderful gold objects from 2,000, 3,000 years ago in Western Europe. And there was even a small gold rush in Ireland about 100 years ago. But nonetheless, gold has been neglected. In fact, one of the good things, if you like, that the Dalradian people have done is by going full tilt and developing their deposit, applying for a planning application, a lot of people in the industry have begun to realize that Ireland has great potential for gold. Now, we've been at it for perhaps rather longer than the Dalradian people, because I knew from a child of gold having been discovered down an old antimony mine.
So you were one of the first earlier movers into Ireland.
Absolutely. We've been working for 20 years. That sounds a long time. Some people say, oh, we've heard this story before. They've been around for a long time. They haven't even got a mine yet. On the other hand, when industry people come along, they'll say things like, you know, you've done so much in such a short space of time and on peanuts. So it depends upon which end of the spectrum you're looking for. However, you mentioned very kindly the drilling results this summer. They've been absolutely excellent results, but even more than that, they've brought us now to a stage where in the industry we have a project in which we can go out and seriously talk with major industry figures on the basis of a joint venture in what is a very big area. We have about 500 square miles, that sort of order. And because we've been working before other people even realized that Ireland had gold potential, we have 100% of that area under the Irish licensing regulations. So long as you perform your work commitments, you can hold your acreage. Also, the licenses give you the exclusive right to mining development. So it's a very good situation.
Well, we can say thank you to Dalradian, because
we
I think they have put Ireland back on the map.
Very much so.
In the fact that they just got acquired by Orion. So now
they
have brought the focus into back into
Absolutely.
Ireland.
No, this is so true.
Hopefully you will benefit from it as well.
I hope so, indeed. And full credit to them. We wish them very well with it. But certainly Ireland is now coming from an industry point of view, whatever about the share market. And we've only got a tiny share capital, which, as you can imagine, bears little or no relationship to the actual potential asset value. Because in the assets, we've already demonstrated over 500,000 ounces at one central area called Clontibret, and there's obviously a great deal more to come there, and some of the drilling this season confirmed that. But as well as that, Clontibret itself is only one part of a 15-kilometre gold stretch, Glenish, Clontibret and Clay Lake, all of which we have drilling in and all of which is looking extremely good. And then quite apart from that, we have a series of other properties, gold hotspots, as it were, over approximately 50 miles. So it's a very big project indeed. In fact, we call it the Longford Down Project. That's the sort of geological, as it were, term for it, but it's also the practical term for what we'll be developing.
So you've published assay results on 8 drill holes, and what is your drilling campaign for the summer, and how many assay hole results can we expect in the coming few weeks?
Well, we haven't completed the program yet. It'll be a 10 drill hole program. There are still 2 more holes to come from Clontibret, and also we'll be putting in a hole in Glenish, which is down to the southwest, and one at Clay Lake up to the northeast. So there's quite a major program coming in. And of course, now we've got to the stage when we can forecast, or geologists can forecast, with considerable degree of confidence what a drill hole is likely to intersect. So it's a lot of the work now is confirmatory work, converting, for example, what are known as inferred resources into indicated resources, which means a lot in the industry.
And is that what your plan is for the that half a million ounces you currently have? That is our plan,
and probably also having discussions with major industry companies with a view now, because we've reached the stage when we can seriously look to develop a property to bring in a mine or possibly even mines in the area. So it's been very much a turning point this year from years of slow, patient work on the ground, taking samples, looking at rocks, putting in a hole here, putting in a hole there, onto the situation in which we can very confidently look at a multi-million ounce resource. And in industry terms, gold industry terms, that is a very big potential target.
And so when you've completed the 10-hole drill program, what is your next step that you're going to be doing with the projects?
Next step would have probably been a decision on what should we move forward on in relation to bringing in a mine. Should we move forward immediately, as we could do, in bringing in an immediate shallow open pit mine, for example? Or should we, in actual fact, probably move further down along the line to begin to see just how many million ounces have we got there? So we'll be looking at that, and we'll be discussing it with the majors. They would probably prefer us to continue, if they're coming in as joint venture partners, with the multi-million ounce thing rather than the smaller one. That's very understandable.
Very understandable. People who want to invest in a project or joint venture, they want to make sure that the ounces are available there.
Absolutely.
In order to put a mine in production.
Indeed. Very
makes
much
a lot so. Of sense.
Yeah.
So would you? So you could possibly consider another drill campaign for the fall season as well.
We could indeed. Yes, we'll probably follow up on this one, both at Clontibret and possibly also at Glenish and Clay Lake, the adjacent areas, and maybe one or two holes elsewhere. But our concentration is on the northeast, where we know we already have quite a few ounces, and it's a question of bringing them into the sort of categories that the geologists are comfortable with.
And you have enough cash at this point to
complete? We have cash at the moment. Inevitably, with a company like ours going through the exploration phase, we've had to put in money, and then you come back for more money and your share price goes down like that. And a lot of people have seen that, and quite rightly, I'm sure, because I've put in a lot of my own money, probably about $3 million so far, and I've also seen the decline in share price. But it's all done with a purpose, and the purpose is to make a major economic discovery. And there are very few gold discoveries in the world which are looking at multi-million ounce deposits, and it's 100% owned by us. And that is, although the stock market may not yet perhaps recognize it, very understandably, we find in the industry more and more people are talking with us.
Well, it certainly gives shareholders a lot more confidence when they see that management has put their own money on the line with them. So you're taking as much risk as they are in order to move a project forward. And, and we know that in mining, it can take a long time to put something into production.
You're so right.
But there is, you're right, there's very few projects still left that are close to surface.
And we're in a politically stable country. We're in an area where you've got excellent infrastructure. If you're building a mine in somewhere like Africa, as you might expect, you may have to build a road, bridges, perhaps bring in a power line or rely on diesel. But even in areas such as Western Australia, if you get a nice deposit in the outback there, you still have a lot of work to do and expense on your infrastructure. And you have to fly people in and out. You have a mining camp, whereas in Ireland, no. There are villages, towns, accommodation, infrastructure, you name it. Power supply is actually running through our property. And as well as that, you have a government which is well known to be business friendly, is very supportive of mining and mining history. So there's a lot going for it there.
Oh, that's fantastic. So I guess we can expect some future news flow on some more assay results
indeed.
Coming forward.
Absolutely.
And, you know, possibly future discussions with partners going in the future.
Indeed.
Thank you very much, Richard, for joining
us
and telling us all about the company. Thank you for joining us on Share Talk, and have a very profitable day.